Photoshop has a number of selection tools that can help us select objects in the image based on the contents of the image, including the colors, the tones, and the edges. So in this first image, I want to make some changes to portions of the image, starting with the scarecrow's pumpkin head. In order to do this, I'm going to select the object selection tool. As soon as I select that, it will enable the object finder, and Photoshop will try to find objects in the image with the help of machine learning. So as I position my cursor over these pumpkins, we can see that Photoshop is automatically identifying them as an object. If I click on them, it will load that as a selection. If I wanted to add to the selection, I could hold down the Shift key and continue clicking. But I actually want to select the scarecrow's head, so I'll release the Shift key and just click in order to select it. Then on the Layers panel, I'm going to add a Hue and Saturation Adjustment layer. I just want to change the hue a bit, moving the pumpkin's head more towards red. Now, if I want to soften the edge of the selection, I can switch to the Mask icon on the Properties panel and then increase the feather amount. If I hold down the Option key on Mac or the Alt key on Windows and we click on the Mask, we can watch as I move the feather slider to the right how it softens the edge. All right, I'll just back off a little bit there and toggle the visibility of the layer on again. Now, if the object finder doesn't automatically find the area that you're trying to select, in this case, for example, I want to select the pants, not the entire scarecrow, we can go in and manually select one of these two modes, either the rectangle or the lasso mode, and then try to draw a selection around the area that we want to select. In this case, we can see that Photoshop has kind of shrink-wrapped the selection around the pants, but there's a lot of area that's still selected that I don't want selected. So let's see if there's maybe a better way. I'm going to switch from the Object Selection tool to the Quick Selection tool. Now, we could try the Magic Wand tool. It's a great tool. It's been around forever, and it's really useful when you're trying to select large areas of uniform color, like maybe a large swath of blue sky. But with the pants in this image, I think Quick Select is going to be a better choice because it has edge detection built into it. So not only is it selecting based on color, but it will also look at the edges. All right, I'm going to use Command D to deselect. So we're starting kind of with a blank slate. And then I will position the tool over the pants and then click. And even if I release the cursor, you'll notice there's a plus icon because Photoshop has automatically swapped me to the Add To option for this tool. So I'll just keep dragging over the red areas here of the pants. And each time I click on a color, under the hood, Photoshop is creating a color table. So this tool actually gets more accurate the more you use it. So if I click here and it selects too much, I'll just hold down the Option key and then remove these colors. And as I start removing, for example, the background there and the hay, it's going to refine that color table and it will do a better and better job of selecting. Of course, we can always use these tools in combination with, say, the lasso or the marquee. Just tap the L key, that would give me the lasso tool. Same shortcuts work, right? Holding down the Shift key is going to add to the selection. Holding down the Option or the Alt key would subtract from the selection. All right, I just want to darken down these pants. So in the Layers panel, I will choose the Brightness and Contrast Adjustment layer, and then we'll just decrease the brightness there a bit. All right, I'll tap the W key to return to the Quick Select tool, and this time I'm going to drag it over the jacket here. Again, it's going to automatically give me that plus or add to selection. We've got a little too much here, so I'll hold down the Option key to remove those color values. And then let's add a color fill layer. From the bottom of the Layers panel, I'll use that adjustment icon again. I'll choose solid color, but we can see that it's just adding a solid color over it. I'm not seeing any of the luminosity values underneath, but I can still pick a blue color. And then in the Layers panel, I'm going to change the blend mode to color, so only the color values are affected and not the photograph or the luminosity values underneath it. All right, let's zoom in to 100% using Command 1. And I'm going to switch to the paintbrush by tapping the B key. because I see there's some areas here that I don't want to have that blue tint. So in the layers panel, I'll target the mask and I'll just make sure that I'm painting with black, and I can paint over any of the areas that I don't want to be affected by that color fill layer. I can also tap the X key, so now I'm painting with white, and I'll just paint in this area because I do want that to be affected. You might think, wait, why are you painting so much? Sometimes it's just easier to paint a large area and then tap the X key and come back in and subtract that area, as opposed to trying to go in with a really, really small brush to get that little edge. Oh, I also need to subtract this area here. I didn't see that, so let's remove that. And then I'll use Command 0 on Mac, Control 0 on Windows in order to zoom out. So as we can see, Photoshop has several tools which can help create selections. And even if they're not perfect with just a single click, it's great to know that we can always go in and refine them using the other selection tools or by painting in the mask.